Hey, who may be a leader of family? I know we've been doing a walkthrough talking about biblical counseling framework for life, but if any of y'all have been with me for a while, you know that Chuck Swindoll is one of my mentors, and I really love the way he teaches. I love his openness. I love his straightforwardness, and I love his truths. And I got an article here that I thought was appropriate just to go right along with what we're dealing with, because we're trying to get sound information to you that you may be able to understand what God is truly calling you to do. Now, Chuck named this this article "In the World But Not of It," and that's some of the things that we was talking about. 1 John 2:15 say, "Do not love the world nor the things that are in the world." And so I want to give you about four principles. I'm not going to even hold you that long, because I just wanted to share these with you, because I think that you need to hear those. And myself, when I read them, I thought they was excellent to go right along with what we are talking about. Now, when you're talking about, listen at number one, pay close attention to what you look at. Our eyes seem to be the closest connection to our mind. The scripture talk about renewing your mind, because a lot of us come into Christ and we've been out in that world for so long, sometimes we don't allow the word of God to penetrate us, because we got our thoughts from that world. And a lot of times, sometimes it's difficult for us to let go of something that mom and dad said, somebody on the corner, some neighbor, some uncle, whatever, because we so respect what they've said. But if it bumps up against the word of God, then we need to let go of it. So we need to make sure that we're paying attention to what we're looking at. Because whatever the scriptures say, your eyes is the windows to your soul, and the things that you look at sometimes can damage your soul. Number two, give greater thought to the consequence of sin than to its pleasure. Nobody ever mentioned the ugly underside of pleasurable sin. Nobody ever tells you that. Matter of fact, we don't even think about that. We just think about how good it's going to make us feel. We don't think as far as and play the whole thing out. Now, I'm going to tell you something. It's not that I haven't fell into sin before, because I have fell into it and had some trouble getting out of it. But the thing that we need to understand is this. We need to understand that God wants us to think about this pleasure. He wants us to think about it more than... He wants us to think about the ugly side of it. Number three, begin each day by renewing your sense of reverence for God. Start each new day by talking to the Lord, even if that early morning talk has to be brief. We need to spend time with God before we go out into this world, because God needs to be able to penetrate our thoughts. He needs to be able to get into our mind and what we thinking. And that's why I always tell people, when I'm examining my life, what I do is to bring my thoughts before God, and I let him examine them so he can instruct me on them. And I tell you that really helps me before I go out into this world. And number four, periodically during each day, focus fully on Christ. Imagine him as he is thinking about you, praying for you, standing with you, and living in you. And so that's what I'm saying. The scriptures say, pray without ceasing, dwell on whatever is good and honorable and true. And God is calling us to dwell on that. And those are four principles that I thought would go right along with what we're talking about. So I hope you was able to jot those down, because they're very important. Like I say, I really respect the teaching of Chuck Swindoll, and I wanted to share those with you. Hey, until we see you next time, as we continue to talk about the biblical counseling framework for life, may God bless you and keep you as our prayer. And remember, examine your life so you can balance your life.